Real estate developer is under house arrest after a federal judge ruled that he willingly violated his bond. 4029's Yugoci Aloka shows us what's next in the Brandon Barber fraud case. She's live and local. Yugoci?
We're outside the Chancellor Hotel in Fayetteville, where right now Brandon Barber is under house arrest. Barber is charged with bank fraud and money laundering. Barber's attorney tells us the judge's decision could have been a lot harsher.
I don't think it was generous. I do think that it could have been worse. I do think she could have revoked his bond and incarcerated him in Arkansas.
Today, a federal judge reviewed Barber's current house arrest conditions. After Barber was arrested and charged with bank fraud and money laundering, he thought the house arrest terms were too strict. Barber's attorney says the house arrest terms interferes with his ability to make money.
It's going to be very difficult, as my father indicated, to stay at home 24/7 and job hunt. It's just very difficult to do that with interviews or without meeting people. There's very limited number of jobs you can have at the home.
Currently, Barber lives with his fiance. Prosecutors say Barber violated house arrest on April 25th when he left his New York home for 3 hours without telling his probation officer. Meantime, a family court hearing is being held tomorrow in New York to discuss a restraining order against Barber, stating that he can't be around his fiance's kids. The judge says if that court rules to uphold the restraining order, Barber can't live with his fiance anymore. Barber's attorney tells 4029 News what Barber is mostly concerned about.
His mind is on his children. I mean, he's not going to be able to, if you heard the testimony, not going to be able to spend the time he needs to with his children.
Depending on the outcome on the family court hearing in New York, Barber could be back in federal court as early as tomorrow to finalize his living arrangements. Live tonight, Yugoci Aloka, 4029 News.
And Barber's trial is scheduled to start in mid-June. Now